Oh, guys, I almost forgot. Sparky, the charged creeper. Alright, you guys, so just west of Palartica, we have Palumbra, which is this outpost slash village that I rebuilt after it was destroyed by the Cobra Empire. So we have a lot of villager guys here, a lot of houses, some farms. This dude right here, the enforcer, who I don't like very much because he killed Lieutenant Lefty, and I'm very upset about that still. But yeah, I went and put these patterns in all the houses. So we got these chorus fruit right here. We have a lot of villagers. Let's see, Farmer Daniel, this dude, Fred, Caretaker John, who is like the very first dude here, been here since the beginning, Yukon, the Caretaker Squirter, there's Johan, Yukon's twin. Nothing much in here. I think that this is the only other place with relevance here, the Master's Quarters, and I guess, you know, the chickens are in charge now because Lefty's gone, but we still have Snowball and Maximus, and yeah, that's basically it. We really gotta get somebody of authority back in here, but I don't know. Maybe we can resurrect Lefty with one of the Skull Shrines someday. Alright guys, now we are in Wellspire, and I haven't done too much here besides put this rogue pumpkin soldier here, because, well, actually, he kind of put himself here. But there is one significant thing that I did add to this, because Wellspire is the birthplace of the Skult. So, naturally, there has to be something Skulty here. So right here is the Skult Spire, and the way to get into this is swim up, and then you go down the top part. So there's a couple levels that are just here for decoration, I guess, but the good stuff is down here. Oh, where the traitorous guards lie. But we have a meeting room right here. Nothing much about this. We have Palumbran artifacts, which is where I store several items with relevance to the story, like a nickel and sword from the Keepers of the Crystal event, and some of Rannak's gear from one of Kento's storylines. We have a bunch of weapons and such from various allies, and even more everyday items from some of the other guys, with the god banners that I kind of showed you before. Right here we have the treasure vault, some of the Skult riches, no diamonds because, you know, we're not placing those down. And last but not least, the resurrection shrine, and this, if anything, is going to bring back Lefty, but we'll have to wait for that. But yeah, this is, I think this is the smallest shrine. There's not really much in here. I should have made it bigger, but I didn't. But yeah, this one's kind of unstable. You know, the reason that Esmond's filled with all these undead things is because this one's kind of broken, so, you know, once we fix this, we'll get Lefty back. Now, what we have here is kind of a secret project that I gave up on a long time ago, but this was supposed to be, like, a Halloween-themed volcano hideout of some kind. So, yeah, there's an actual volcano down there. You probably can't really see it, but yeah, all that I really did was this walkway. There's the lava right there. I actually died in there once. So the next place that we have to visit is Venomora, which is not mine anymore, but it was once a Skult territory that I have had great influence over, like the banners, the new name, but it was originally a Cobra Empire place, or actually I think before that it was Tatros's. But this was also the site of the semi-recent pillager raid, and toilet paper. And this place, I don't know, it seems like a ghost town. There's some guys somewhere, I don't know where they are. Oh, they're all jammed in here, but yeah, there's a few survivors of this place. If you cross the bridge here, there's this tower with a beacon that I installed, and yes, that wandering traitor is still present. I don't know why, I don't know how, but he's here. Now there's a few other relevant locations like Tatros, Reverie, Keepers of the Crystal, but I haven't really built anything there, but long story short, I invaded both Tatros and Reverie and I'm part of the Keepers of the Crystal faction, but we are going to be going to the Forbidden Kingdom. Now, once you get here, you pop out right into the Palumbran Mesa Station slash base That's, yeah, Lumber and Mesa Station. I know, great acronym, right? But you got Edward here, the seventh Dark Journal on a lectern, one of the great banners. Stop covering it up, you snob. And up here you have some sculpt pedestals of some kind. And then over here you have the Forbidden Farmhouse, where the Palumbran Empire kind of provides food to what's little is left of this place with Farmer Dave. But that's really all that I have done here besides place some banners near the entrance. But this place is where the end portal is, and where the finale of the story, the end game, took place. Now, if you come up here, however, this is something that I had more to do with. So, this is the end game outpost, the official Palumbran Mesa base that was used as our base of operations before the end game began. And I didn't do the tents and stuff. This was Mini, Zare, Kento, and I'm not sure if there was other people involved. But we have Oscar here. We have Sergeant Doug Mason, the Mesa Hound. In here, we have one of the Dark Journals. I think this is the sixth one. And the fourth one was in Palumbra, by the way, in the General's Quarters. And this is Pumpkin right here, one of the cats. That's it for this place. There's nothing really in these anymore. There's like some bed tents, enchanter tents, food tents. It's pretty much been cleaned out already, so yeah, there's nothing left to see here. Alright, so our next location is the Lost Kingdom, which used to be Forges until he gave it to me. And while he built a lot of this stuff, I filled it up with these villagers right here. So, one thing that I kind of finished was the Skull Headquarters for this place, where we also have a shrine. So I did the entire interior of this building, and this may be a bad decision. Ah, die, fool! Oh, okay. But we also have the Endurance Shrine, which, actually, now that I think about it, this may be the smallest shrine. So, this kingdom has, like, a armory and a blacksmith, but this was all Forges doing, pretty much. I just added some profession blocks and pandas. And speaking of pandas, this castle courtyard, which is kind of off-limits now, is filled with pandas because I was messing around with them for the longest time. And there's actually a few villagers who escaped me here. The servants' quarters is where they like to stay. And, ah, here he is. This is the guy I wanted to see. Not the cat. King Nitty Witty. The guy who kind of just made himself at home in this big castle and started his own village. Now, this part over here is where it gets interesting. So, aside from Jungle Baby, we have the Palumbran Wildlife Reserve, something of the sort. Exotic animal, okay. And this is where all the pandas are kept, among other things like mushrooms. But we have at least one of every type of panda in here somewhere, including the brown pandas, which there should be four of. And we also have, you know, Lazy Bones over here, a few other guys. There's a few angry ones, playful ones. We have a baby brown one, once again. And now I can actually show you guys the baby brown panda without other ones attacking me, looking at you, eyebrows. Yeah, that's right. He knows what he did. But, yeah, we have baby brown panda, grown-up brown panda, and another brown panda, and Ozzy the ocelot right here. We have more pandas over here, more ocelots, other stuff, trees, and our last brown panda. Now, this is the last thing that I did in this kingdom, because, well, this is kind of like the sculpt base. Forge built, like, the outside, but the inside was completely empty, so what I did was I finished it. This is the bee farm of the server. I don't know if there's been more, but this was, at the very least, the first one. So, we got some bees, and we have four of them, so here's number one. Number two is right here. Oh, hello, bees. And then upstairs we have Bee Farm 3 and Bee Farm 4. So, yeah, you can get the honeycombs or the bottles, whichever you want. Alright, so this is Voldera, which used to belong to Toby until he gave it to me. And while I haven't built a lot of things in here, there are a few mob characters and such, and one room that I did build. So first up, we have Henry, the former sentry, who is now the blacksmith. But you know, this has gone out of business, so he's kind of just rotting away here. We have Toby's old buddy Jerry in the fish and spell shop. And up here, this is where my thing is. So, you know, here's more stuff you can buy. But this is the employees only room, which is the Skolt Quest's room that hasn't really been used, except I think I was in here like once. But this is Victor. He kind of gives out the Skolt Quest. So, you know, if we actually do one again, this is where we'll go. But while I'm here, I think that we should see Mike and Maya, the very first captive mob things of the server, at least I think so, I don't know. But it was these guys that Toby got that kind of inspired me to capture mobs of my own, because the thing was like, oh, well, Toby's got slimes, well, I'm gonna do something even cooler and get a magma cube. And, you know, then I got Cuber, and then I got carried away with all these other guys. Alright, so we're down to our last three places of the tour, or, well, three and a half, I guess. But this is Traveler's Landing, and I've built a couple things here, such as this portal building. And we have Scout here. This is my apartment thing, where we keep Gary, one of the parrots, as well as Freddy the Fox, and he still doesn't like me very much. But this is also where the Crimson Journal is kept. That's almost all of the journals that I... The Kingdom of the Skolt has the third one down in the basement. But yeah, out here we also have this balcony and Banditos Burritos. So, Banditos Burritos right here is Traveler's Landing's cowboy burrito shop with Rusty the manager and our buddy Jeff over here. Jeff the legendary chef and all the burritos you could ever want. So, yeah, free burritos, by the way. Jeff is a very generous guy. He loves to share his burritos with the world. They're totally not baked potatoes or anything. Shh. But we better get out of here because the angry patrons are here and they must not be satisfied. They must have figured out that the burritos are actually potatoes. Ah! Oh no! Run away! Now up here is where the Crimson Shadow lives, and if you don't know who that is, it's like my secondary character that kind of introduces where I came from. You know, me, Darkblade. it's a whole thing. But yeah, this is his house, and the banners have kind of changed since I last showed you, but basically you just come in here, he's got all the mob heads mounted on the walls, some Nyshin banners, a nice crimson bed, and here's some of his gear. So, you know, we got all this business, crimson stuff, some iron. He's got some goodies, and he's also got a frenemy of some sort up here, along with this, like, zoo thing. All the lost animals of the Kingdom of the Skolt, which is right down there, by the way. We've also got Harry, the husk with the sword. He's like Crimson's lookout, you know. He's just chilling up here, and if you get too close, he will slice you, so we don't want to do that. But he's kind of watching over Crimson's pets, I guess. I don't know, they are both my characters, I guess, so, you know, they gotta have all the mobs look at all that stuff down there. But check this out. Kingdom of the Skolt is right here. Everything's packed into kind of one location. So, the Kingdom of the Skolt was also called Castin when it belonged to Tatros, and it was the worship place of Atristan, and I have since taken it over, lost it, and then I kind of fixed it up a bit. So I mean, the story's over, so I kind of consider it mine again. I don't know. Correct me if I'm wrong, but it's not like anyone else pays attention to this place, and it's still being called the Kingdom of the Skolt. But, you know, I still like to torment the keepers every now and then. These iron golems aren't looking too good, but unfortunately it's nighttime, so everybody's going to be hiding in their homes. Ah, yes, here's my best friend. He's the jungle farmer. He's been a loyal friend. We also have a singular panda, and this lake, which I have really come to like with the bamboo and stuff, and there's also a beehive. Oh lord, the zombie siege. They're all coming for me now. We had better get inside. I would sleep, but Tekkit's here, and every time I want to sleep, he's got to log out. which is unfortunate, so I don't really want to bother him anymore. But we've got a bunch of dudes gathered up in here for some reason. I don't know what their deal is. This is kind of the mansion, and there's been some drama with this, you know, the carpet and taking it over. You know, Toby Forge and I all took this place over together, and I've kind of introduced villagers into the interior of this place, so, you know, they all live in here. It's all good. We got a slight farm next to this guy. The villagers don't use it, unfortunately. But, yeah, that's it. The third journal is down there, but there's nothing down there. It's not worth going all the way down there to see. And then, in here, we just have a bunch of cats. Alright, guys, we are on to the final destination of the tour. The infamous Skult Temple, with Lord Skulton himself here to greet us, and if you get too close, he too will slice you and wither you and murder you. So yeah, stay away from him. He really wants to smack somebody. I can see his arms. He's just waiting to swing that sword of his. But we have this guy to calm him down. He's like his guard slash advisor. He used to be too, but you know, he tech it, like deleted him or something. But yeah, we got some Skult warriors in here. There's more down here, you know, guarding the main level of the temple, and it's been lit up. I showed you guys this with shaders, but I haven't shown you guys the temple without them yet. So we have the Skult Wildcat right there. Old Unreliable, our unintelligence, I guess. We have the Shadow Horses. So in here we have the Wither Horse, which is the baby of the two Shadow Horses, as well as Skeletor, the main skeleton horse that I rode across Esten with Tombstone that one time. And outside is a terrible place, but we're going to go out there anyway, because Skult Warrior is fighting, and there's also a Skult Warrior that way towards the coast that kind of went AWOL on us. But yeah, this is the outside of the temple. We got a black beacon that you probably can't really see in the nighttime. Skeletons, pandas, these two amazing statues that Toby built. I really love these. Down here, in the catacombs, this is where stuff gets good. So we got the Skult Lounge. We have another buddy in here, Skult Warrior. We have Lux the Tux, Tuxedo Cat. Dead Skult Warriors. We have the remaining Skult Hounds. There's only three of them because the fourth one betrayed us. He attacked Lord Skulton. Spooky music time as we conclude the tour. So we come down here, and this is the final Skull Shrine with a guard, of course, the Master Shrine. And in here we have, of course, you know, the typical shrine and such, and the Clash of Bosses monument. And this is when I fought the dragon and the wither at the same time. So we got the dragon's head, some nether stars, and a wither rose. And this is kind of what, you know, corrupted the worlds and everything and brought the Crimson Shadow here, so, you know, sorry about that. But anyway, coming down here, we have more stuff. Toby kind of did the tunnels and such, but I did a lot of the rooms, so this is the meeting room. Toby did this one, and he did this magma blocks in the wall thing, and I really love that, so I really did that with the rest of the temple. We also have Skult banners and some spare shulker boxes. In here, we have the Skult Armory. Lag is really bad today for some reason. And in here is where I keep all of my personal gear. So we have Illuminator 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. And these are all different. They may have similar enchants on some of them, but they're all different bows. And we also have, I think this is Claude's Armor. And my alternate set of tools. Hate of an Angel, Guillotine, Soulbreaker, Great Spider Killer, these are some more tools and stuff, and the Depressor, which is a bow. And the one I'm using right now is Illuminator Zero. Now back down here, we have the Skult Warriors guarding my room, and in here you will find Eerie and Tombstone, the dog who slayed Lucius in Waypoint. Very proud of this guy. He's like my favorite dog, but he's had some experiences, you know. And I believe that this is the fifth Dark Journal. And in here we just have the Keepers of the Crystal Clues, Potions of healing and regen, some more knight helmets, and spare shulker boxes. And over here, I know it doesn't say so, but this is Medical's room, and he can change the sign if he wants. He can do whatever he wants in here, build whatever. So the prison is down this last door. And right here we have our magma cubes, Magmike and Magmaya, which is like the demonic counterparts of Mike and Maya from earlier. The very first build that I was actually proud of, the Tomb of the Skult. And Spooky Bart, the father of Spooky Bart Jr., who was eaten by Tombstone, sadly. but yeah, Spooky Bart, he's kind of become depressed, so he guards the cemeteries. Man, you're fast. But yeah, he still mourns the loss of his son and, you know, the other Bart Jr., but this is like the grand tomb, you know. Maybe this is where Skulton rose from. Down here is the prison, and we have one last Skult warrior guarding the place. We have Deadeye, the biggest troublemaker and the most dangerous prisoner of them all. We have our first prisoner, Catherine the Zombie, along with Zombert, the farmer dude. We have Jungle Jim back there. He replaced the Dimwit who was eaten by one of these guys. The Siamese twins right here, along with the prisoner of war, the Keeper, who's going crazy, as you can see, just staring up at this wall. And that's it for the prisoners, but we do have a secret room right down here. So, you come all the way down here, and you'll find the witch's camp. So this is where the escaped prisoner, Agatha, resides, and this is the last mob, the last place that we have on the tour. Down here we just got some mob heads, her victims, a tent, a campfire, and of course the brewing station and netherwork, because she's still gotta make her potions, you know? Alright, so that is it for the 1 year anniversary tour of the server and the things that I've built and done and such. And yeah, it was a lot, but that's what you get with 70 episodes. And hopefully there are plenty more to come. I currently need ideas, but yeah, I'm just gonna run around Vacuo for a little bit because this place is so cool. It's one of my new favorite places on the server, and it's got no owner, so you know, I can just run about as I please. But yeah, guys, that is it for this episode. I hope that you all enjoyed, and I will see you guys in the next one. Goodbye!